What's up guys, welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. Yeah, so today I want to show you how to code. Even if you have no experience, after watching this video you should have a pretty good idea how to code. I'm gonna make this video in four parts, okay? So this will be just sort of like the introduction, okay? So this should give you a pretty general idea of how to code in just about any language. And yeah, people think coding is extremely difficult, but it's actually very simple. Now for coding, the most important things are variables, okay? So you need to learn those first. You have strings, which is a text, integers, a number. You got floats, which is a number with a decimal, okay? Like 1.5 or something like that. And booleans, okay? Which is just on and off, or true or false. So the first thing we're going to do is actually just learn how to display text on the screen. Alright, that's very, very important. Now you could do this in Notepad if you wanted to, I mean it doesn't really matter. Now, but if you're looking for an easy language to get started coding, I would say HGK2 is probably one of the most simple languages out there. It's not, and it's not only simple, but it's actually super, super powerful. Okay, you can do just about anything in HGK2. So yeah, so let's open HGK2, and let's go File New. Let's call this, I'm gonna call this Spark, just because we can. Okay, let's create the project, okay, that automatically saves. Now if you run this, you're going to notice that nothing happens. Well, other than it displays the FPF, right? Those forward slashes are comments, okay. This is nothing, you don't need to worry about this. Let me just set the stage size to 640 by 480. Okay, this is the window size. And for the resolution, I guess I can set this to 640 by 480 as well. It doesn't actually have to match the window size. Now for the sync, now for the sync rate, I can set this to 60 FPF. Okay. You usually set it to 30 to save battery on mobile devices. That's because HGK2 is geared towards mobile devices. You can make games for anything in HGK2. Let me take out that print. Take that out. You don't actually need it. Let's put that out of the way, and this here is the actual program. All right, so anything you put before the do runs only once, okay? Anything you put after the do, it keeps running, okay, continuously, sort of like an always if you were using another software. I got an Undertale background here we're gonna use. Let me just save this, and I'm going to paste that inside the project. Under media, Carl, it's just called Undertale.png. Let's load the background. All you have to type is create sprite, load image, round brackets, and the name of the your file, which is Undertale.png. Let's try it out. And there is our background. All right. So let's create some text here. I'm gonna go create text. The number of the text, this is going to be text 1, and in our text string, which is going to be hello world. So if you run this, we are going to get an error message, and that's because text 1 already exists. Yeah, so remember, after the do is looping, okay, so it's already created this text once, and it cannot create it again. So let's cut the text, and let's paste it before the do. Okay, so let's run this. And wow, the text is so small you can't see it, so we need to make it bigger. So we're gonna set the text size, and the number of the text is 1, and for the size I'm gonna set it to 24. So let me just run this. There is our text. So let's set the text position. The ID is going to be ID 1, two zeros, one for the X and Y. Let's set the X to 200, and let's set the Y to 300. Run this. Okay, so maybe we can bring it down a little more. Let's set the Y to maybe 40, and maybe a little lower. Let me see. Let me try 43. Okay, so that works fine. We can also set the text bold. Okay, type the ID of the text. I'm gonna set this to 2. You see that my text is now showing in bold. Set text color. The ID of the text is 1. And we're gonna type 4 zeros. Okay. Now the first three zeros is for RGB, red, green, and blue. We're gonna set the red to 255. Okay, that's the green there. Set it back to zero. We set the first one to 255. 255 red. Oh, we forgot the opacity. The opacity is set to zero, so that makes it invisible. Let's set it to up to 255, which is the highest number you can set for these values. And there is our text. Okay, so you don't want to do too much the first time you're trying this. So try this out first. And so in the next video, we're going to do variables. Okay, guys, hit the like button and see you in the next video. Bye now.